news reporter of the New World Order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Files news report, man. This Rona still out here shaking shit down. That's across the entire globe. You see the logo. Make sure you check out blackfilesnews.com/shop and support. Nevertheless, 2.5 million confirmed coronavirus cases, COVID-19 cases worldwide. 178,000 people have fell to that, fatality due to that Rona. You know what I'm saying? And, BFN World Broadcast number 722, the link to that is on Black Fox News Documentary. We're in the broadcast section of the website. We break down basically how people should be treating this situation. It's from months ago, weeks ago, pardon me. But definitely go check that out. You have top officials though worldwide, like at the David Beasley, the executive director of the World Food Program, and top United Nations officials basically saying governments need to act. Take some urgent steps in order to prevent a wave of hunger, basically. David Beasley talking about 265 million people could worldwide could end up being hungry. Am I already included in that? Nigga been hungry already. That's what they're talking about. So you take out how you want to do it. What up, the New World Order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So 45,000 deaths of COVID-19 in the United States, reportedly or whatever, confirmed cases. Numbers believed to be a little higher, or a lot higher in some instances due to the lack of testing. There's been a $484 billion economic stimulus package, a new one that's actually been approved by the Senate yesterday. So this is actually going to allocate $310 billion towards the Paycheck Protection Program. That's the loan that goes to all the small businesses, the loan grant or whatever it is. You're talking about the $60 billion going towards emergency disaster funds, $25 billion towards testing, $65 billion towards $75 billion towards hospitals. And there's actually a outcry. You have progressive lawmakers calling for a $2,000 monthly stipend for families and people to get into that and open enrollment for Medicare for the uninsured and unemployed. So there's a tug of war going on. House and Senate are actually on recess and extended it up until May 4th. And they actually have and they're going to come back and, get the vote. We'll see how this turns out. Greenwald and graduate. So the New World Order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. You know what I'm saying? On daddy duty, you feel me? But I still got my duty to the people and, respect to the news channel. Make sure you check out Rona, a.k.a. BFN World Broadcast. You can find that at blackfoxnews.com/broadcast. Reachable through the link in the Black Fox News Instagram bio now. Also, make sure you sign that petition. Get Donald Trump off Twitter, man. Change.org link in the video description. If you're watching this on YouTube, just look it up on change.org now. As we are at a place in our country's history where emoluments is kind of seeming to be the norm almost, because here we are with the Trump Organization is found to be seeking rent relief for the Trump International Hotel in Washington, D.C., which is actually in a federally owned building where the where the Trump administration is leasing that federally owned building. So it's you had the watchdog group, the Common Cause, tweeting out how this is what we call a conflict of interest, also known as corruption or emoluments, unconstitutional violations. You know what I'm saying? I might paraphrase a little bit, but at the same time, you have Trump and the governor of New York, Andrew Cuomo, coming to an agreement to actually ramp up the testing that's been going on in New York for COVID-19, that Rona, you know what I'm saying? And this actually is a place where there's 15,000 people that said to have died from COVID-19 with 250,000 infected in New York State. And the numbers are believed to be higher. Meanwhile, in the empty-ass Times Square, you had immigrants' rights activists like blaring their horns, calling for emergency funding for the undocumented workers when qualified for this stimulus package, $1,200 payment. You know what I mean? They want them to follow suit like the governor of California. Gavin Newsom providing economic relief for those who didn't qualify. So that's what's happening, though. Green Wall tragedy. The New World, though, the Bishop Grady Lake. Y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So remember back on April 7th, across Wisconsin, they actually went ahead with primary elections, for the Democratic presidential candidates. They, instead of postponing the elections, which is what apparently Governor Tony Evers tried to do, via executive order, but that order got overturned by the legislature up there. Nevertheless, fast forward, now at least seven people have actually contracted COVID-19. It's been linked to them voting and to partaking in election day. Keep in mind, Wisconsin has a stay-at-home order, so they would just win against the grain all the way. Over in South Dakota at the Smithfield Food Pork Processing Plant, I've been telling y'all about, a second worker has actually died from contracting COVID-19. That's 761 COVID-19 confirmed cases that have actually been linked to that pork processing plant. And over in Iowa, specifically in Waterloo, Governor Kim Reynolds actually had to shut down a Tyson pork plant that actually is accounting for 90% of all Black Hawk County COVID-19 cases. Greenwood and graduation. Of the New World, though, the Bishop Grady letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So you had an estimated 1,000 people at the state capitol in Raleigh, North Carolina yesterday protesting against the state stay-at-home orders. Now they're doing this in other places as well, like a lot of these conservative groups. In Raleigh, North Carolina, you had some of the protesters holding up signs that were like anti-vaccination and saying like, they're even calling for the firing of Dr. Anthony Fauci, who was actually the top doctor employed by the White House on the coronavirus case. Also the head of the director of the National Institute for Allergies and Infectious Diseases. Now this is somebody that they have a beef with him because he keeps correcting Trump and he's saying out here saying some bullshit. Now there are a lot of conservative groups that have actually been like holding demonstrations like this recently. There's been like groups like Freedom Works and Tea Party Patriot, which is actually backed by Coke Industries, you know what I'm saying? Rest in Pain David Coke, you know what I'm saying? And then you have also like Minnesota Gun Rights. There's even a conservative group linked to Betsy DeVos, who's actually the Secretary of Education. So, those are the cables going all throughout the conservative party, all throughout the country. And motherfuckers is not shooting these people down or anything like that. Imagine if these folks was out there, color. You did. We will graduate. The New World, though, the Bishop Grady letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So on one hand, you got Attorney General William Barr that's actually saying the Justice Department may take legal action against governors who continue to have remain-at-home orders in their states during this pandemic, which is crazy because that goes against what Trump was saying before about letting the governors be able to decide, and that's typically how the Constitution has to set up for the country to work or whatever. So why would there be any legal action taken against governors for deciding after that state is beyond me at the moment, but probably some sneaky snake fuck shit going on. Nevertheless, also, you also had at the same time, out right outside of the White House, National Nurses United, an organization was actually had protests, like dozens of them were actually outside of the White House lawn protesting, calling for shouting out the names of they had a visor actually shouting out the names of 50 healthcare workers who have actually died of COVID-19 since the pandemic, calling out these names and then calling on OSHA, Occupational Safety and Health Administration, to actually require healthcare workers to have adequate PPE, which I thought was already in place. But nevertheless, that's what they requested. 9,200 healthcare workers are said to have actually contracted COVID-19, according to the Center for Disease Control. But the numbers believed to be a lot higher. Green Wall and graduation. For the New World, the Bishop Grady let y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So there's actually a medical examiner in Santa Clara, California, that actually found that there were two people that actually died from COVID-19. And two more people who died from COVID-19 in February, one on February 6th, the other one on the 17th, basically bringing those deaths to about like 2 weeks before Washington State actually reported what was the first U.S. deaths to COVID-19. So that basically lets people know that clearly this virus has actually been circulating around the U.S. before, long before previously thought, or at least that's what people are starting to suspect. Green war and graduation.
Hold on, the new world order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. I had to bring it indoors. But check this out, though. There was a actual study conducted by, funded by the National Institutes of Health, looking over the effects of hydrochloroquine and azithromycin, both medicines that have actually been pumped up by President Trump as treatments to coronavirus disease 2019, COVID-19, SARS-CoV-2, that Rona. Now, hydrochloroquine, especially with it being a derivative of chloroquine, which is a anti-malaria drug, that's why Trump has actually been coming out saying, like, well, you know, if you have it, you can use it. Not officially yet, check with your doctor, but, you know, well, this study actually found that there's actually a higher death rate to coronavirus disease 2019 patients that actually take these medicines. And there's a panel of experts on the National Institute of Allergies and Infectious Diseases that concluded recommending against taking those drugs to treat COVID-19. Now, keep in mind that the director of the National Institute of Allergies and Infectious Diseases is Dr. Anthony Fauci, the top coronavirus doctor in the White House on this shit. Now, if conspiracy theories do reign true and he is trying to usher in a vaccine for everyone, you know what I'm saying, then it kind of would seem like there's some incentive for these institutes to actually come up with these results. So just keep that in mind. But if we're going to take this information for what it is, don't take that shit. You know what I'm saying? And Robert Redfield, who's actually director of the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, actually said that he's warning that we may see a second wave of coronavirus disease cases next winter, especially as it this winter will interact with flu season, green war, and graduation. The new world order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. I had to bring shit indoors, just for me. But more on how the country is actually responding to COVID-19. You have hundreds of Amazon workers yesterday actually calling in sick, somewhat in protest, demanding some like pay, demanding like sick pay for this COVID-19 shit, and as well as demanding that some of these warehouses actually be cleaned up. There have been like protests and strikes happening, one in New York, one in the Midwest or whatever, like at some of these Amazon warehouses where people are actually contracting this disease and shit, so it's concerned there. President Trump, meanwhile, has actually suspended permanent residency applications for immigrants, otherwise known as green cards, for 60 days. He already completely shut down immigration for the time being, and he said that this will actually allow for unemployed Americans to actually be first in line for jobs once America reopens. He did, however, not remove visas from temporary farm workers, since these undocumented migrants are considered to be essential to the country's green war and graduate. Southern the world's order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So, 24 asylum seekers at the Prairieland Detention Center near Dallas, Texas, have actually tested positive for COVID-19. Now, there's already been a fear about COVID-19 spreading amongst the jail populations and the immigrant jail populations, which is looked at as even more severe because these people did nothing wrong other than, you know, trying to move to another country. It's not like they're, like, really deliberately committing domestic crimes, right? Over in near Phoenix, Arizona, at the La Palma Correctional Center, which is actually owned by the private for-profit company CoreCivic, jail people are actually signing waivers relieving CoreCivic of any liability for contracting, if you possibly contract COVID-19, in exchange for wearing face masks. You even have to sign some. They have like these like forms, even in Spanish, you know, for these people, basically saying like, you know, you are agreeing basically to sign this paper and get a mask and relieve them of liability. So just straight, the lack of scruples there. Green war and graduation. The new world order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So, you know, over in across the U.S. in these jails, you have some crazy shit happening with this COVID-19 situation. Like, for example, William Garrison, 60-year-old who died from COVID-19 on April 13th. He was actually set in Michigan to actually be released for parole due to his age and being more susceptible to contracting COVID-19 after serving 44 years in prison for a murder that he committed at age 16. He actually died from COVID-19. Over in Ohio at the Marion Correctional Facility, you have 1,800 prisoners that have actually tested positive for COVID-19, along with 100 prison staffers, making it the largest basically the most concentrated coronavirus hotspot in the nation right now. And then also in Arkansas, Governor Asa Hutchinson said 40% of their COVID-19 cases are actually coming from the Cummins Maximum Correctional Facility, Maximum Security Correctional Facility, a prison which actually has 850 people testing positive for COVID-19. Green Warren graduate. What up, the new world order, Bishop Grady, letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So over in southern Greece, you actually had 148 asylum seekers that was at this hotel that had turned into a quarantine center, actually test positive for COVID-19. Most of them are single parents coming from the Democratic Republic of Congo and Cameroon. This comes after, like, there were a couple of asylum-seeking refugee camps in Greece that actually had these coronavirus outbreaks. Over back in the U.S., though, more how we're responding to it. Over in Mexico, for example, you actually have, they're saying what is called, like, phase three of their coronavirus disease outbreak in the whole country of Mexico, with a death toll that is now over 800. Still, U.S. companies like in Ciudad Juarez, where there's like a maquiladora, U.S. factory there. U.S. officials are urging Mexico to actually open up their factories again, essentially, since they're getting shut down due to this COVID-19 spread. Green Warren graduate. The world of the Bishop Grady letting y'all know what the fuck going on for this Black Fox News report. So after an unprecedented drop in crude oil prices, you had President Trump actually promising to actually bail out the U.S. gas and oil industry. The pricing was so bad that you actually had traders paying customers to offload some of these oil. Now, at the same time, you have over in at Oxford University in England, you actually had them agreeing to officially divest from oil and fossil fuel industries with their future endowments. President Larry Bacall of Harvard University pledged to do the same thing for their $41 billion endowment to move it to carbon neutral investments, but only by 2050. And then also the Iran, another news, and mind you, that's weak as hell, but in Iran, they launched their first ever military rocket ship into orbit after a bunch of failures last year, which, and they've long accused the U.S.